Hello everyone, a very good morning to you. Welcome to today's edition of The Bottom Line. Here are the top headlines. New restrictions for international travelers in works at the White House. Airfare prices to Europe hit 5-year low this fall. Airlines can operate 85% of pre-COVID domestic flights. Fiji plans to reopen for tourism soon. Uttarakhand's Chardham Yatra commences, attracts devotees in huge numbers. Hawaii reports growth in hotel revenue. According to the reports, when the United States reopens to international travelers, a new entrance procedure will be in place. The new strategy will include contact tracing. The government, however, has not provided a timeline for the current travel restrictions to be relaxed. Jeff Zients, the White House's coronavirus response coordinator, stated, "The American people need to trust that the new system for international travel is safer. We'll be letting in more travelers. We are exploring considering vaccination requirements for foreign nationals traveling to the US." Since the Europe's new travel advisory began on August 30th, airfare from the US to Europe has reached its lowest rates in the past 5 years, according to Hopper's Travel to Europe report. This report analyzes data from its app to reveal search trends, booking data, and more. Certain cities have seen the biggest price drops, but individuals flying round-trip to Europe can expect average rates of less than $600, even lower than March 2020's average rates, which were at $750 round-trip. Given the current situation, the Indian Aviation Ministry has said that the airlines can now operate at a maximum of 85% of their pre-COVID domestic flights. Earlier, the number was capped at 72.5%, allowed till date. The Ministry of Civil Aviation on Saturday said that till now, airlines were not operating to their capacity due to the highly contagious coronavirus. The order also said that the 72.5% cap will remain in place until further order. That's a wrap on today's edition of The Bottom Line. Thank you for joining us. For more such tourism and travel industry updates, stay tuned to tomorrow. Have a great day ahead.